My name is Josh Farver. Wife and family and I are your missionaries sent out by Saylorville Church in Togo, West Africa, serving at the Hospital of Hope. We have five children. Allie and Abby, our twin girls, are 14. Tim is 13. Trey is 11. And Jackson is 4. So we've been on the field for one term, just wrapped up almost a year ago in December, and are finishing up our first furlough, and then we will be heading back to the field. We have five national chaplains that I work with, along with a couple other missionaries, and so I lead this group in sharing the gospel with people in the hospital, praying, encouraging, counseling people. From that also, we are doing Bible studies and follow-up in the village. So we have a lot of opportunities to get out and go through chronological studies, and we're seeing large numbers of people come to Christ and give their faith to Christ. The area that we're in Togo is very needy. There are many physical needs, a lot of illness and just disease and things like that. And so the hospital is just a great way to meet people in their time of need. And that, again, opens up doors for the gospel. People are open and willing to talk about spiritual things. And even though we're in a Muslim city, 95% Muslim, the people there are open and inviting to us, and they're interested in what we want to share, have to share with them. So for me, I lead the chaplaincy department. We meet each morning and have a time of prayer and just kind of preparation for our day. Then we go around each morning and pray with all of the patients that are in the hospital, get to know them, their families. A lot of people are in there for, you know, a number of days, and gives us the opportunity to get to know them, for that end goal of being invited out to their village then to do those follow-up Bible studies. We also get a lot of opportunities to counsel patients from the clinic. If somebody's diagnosed with cancer or AIDS or, you know, things that are prevalent there, the doctors will always ask, do you want to speak with a counselor? And so at that point, we get to figure out what language they speak, because we're dealing with multiple tribal languages. And so we have a good group of chaplains that cover a lot of those languages, so we can take the appropriate chaplain with, and then we go and have the chance just to encourage them to make sure they understood the diagnosis, and then as the Spirit leads, if they're willing, we have the opportunity to share the gospel with them as well. It's hard to explain, it's hard for people to even grasp the difficulties that there are facing, you know, culture and language and just the conditions in which we're working. We see a lot of death, we see a lot of very hard things, and so, you know, people can always pray for just us to stay fresh in the Word, to stay close in our walk with Christ, because we can't minister to people if we're not in the proper relationship and walking with Christ. The same for our chaplains. We have a group, again, they're seeing a lot of very hard things, their daily challenges and struggles, and so we appreciate our people back here in the States holding up that whole group. The second year of us being open, we saw two deaths within our missionary team. Has been during the time that we've been home, so we haven't been there with the team through this, but it's been a very challenging struggle. And I think a lot of that is just a spiritual battle, because God is really on the move there, and people are being saved and giving their lives to Christ. And I think there's a lot of spiritual battle going on there. We're in a dark area. Again, Islam is prevalent, but there's a lot of animistic religion type things, and, you know, people calling on spirits and voodoo type stuff. And so we see people demon possessed, and we see, you know, a lot of challenges that way. So pray for our spiritual strength and endurance as we continue on the work there.